At the time when we started in the trade, the pub shut at 9:30 for start. And in them days, it was just like a bar. And any woman that, or females that frequented a bar, they were women of all repute. You know, time change would be the fact of women accepted as drinking in the pub. You know, if you want a more recent change, then the next one that was very important, I would say, is the extension of the hours. You don't see people rolling about the gutters drunk now the way you used to. In them days, people came in and it was as much as they could drink within their time limit. You know, would go away and they're rolling
beat the
about.
Beat the clocks,
as Michael says. You know, you're beating the clock sort of thing. That doesn't exist now. If they come in, they could say, well, I would have 3 pints or I would have a pint. They've plenty of time to drink whatever they want to drink.
I think Glasgow suffered a lot from that, didn't it? I mean, Glasgow was the kind of music hall joke, you know, in terms of drunks.
A bad image from that.
Comedians like Harry Lauder created a picture of the wee Scots drunk. Cartoonist Malky McCormick continues the joke, but with more affection. He's been asked by the Brothers Bar in Postle to capture all their brothers for posterity.
Wait till I do you, I tell you. This one thing, the pencil does not lie, gentlemen. You know? Can I fly away here, there?
Fly away for a while, isn't
Aye, that's right, he's getting a bonnet on. Aye, he's really blowing the under there.
What? John might be taking you back now.
You take this green and white scarf if you like, aye. That's a bit thick. I've got it. Look, the big guy's blue, aye.
Emphasise that, will you please?
I'm feeling good, sir.
You play very good, actually, isn't it?
I'm sweet. Put a Celtic scarf for you as well. It's good to reach through. Good. You're a Celtic fan yourself.
Oh, aye.
I'm a donkey, one of them.
I never seen that there last week. I better come on and up. Nobody ever put thistle last week.
That's right.
Can't keep me down, Pertie.
Tell me.
How old is this year? I'm a turtle, Jay.
Well, I think we'll beat them.
I hope so. I've always wanted to meet you, they'll go.
Postle Park is only what people see from the outside, but if you come into the heart of the place, and in this case we're in Postle Park, you could be Easter House, you could be Drumchapel, Castlemock, but we're in Postle Park, it gets a lot of bad publicity, very unfairly. Any area can be a hard area. But if you set the standards that Michael were talking about, keep your decor good, make your service A1, it creates a friendly atmosphere in the place.
In Glasgow pubs, people speak to you. They tend not to let you brood alone. I mean, I've often suggested that Greta Garbo would never have had a chance in Glasgow of being alone. They would have said, who's the big woman with a funny hat? Bring her out here and have a drink. And I think that is... Glasgow pubs have been great talking shops and great places for putting your heart on the counter and let it beat there. And, you know, I've had experiences in Glasgow pubs where people told me their life story in about, within about 5 minutes of meeting them.
I did pretty well. He's fine. I was pleased to see them winning the cup.
The first time a second division team's won the cup.
But when I get a couple of drinks on a Saturday, Glasgow belongs to me.
It's a public house with a newsroom to them. Lots of them, most of them, a great majority of them couldn't read nor write. And the only way they could get news was going up to the pub and sitting with a pint of beer or a half pint of beer. And gradually that half pint of beer went to a pint, and it went to two, and it went to three. And people are always awful kind, public, people in a public house. Oh, one pint will do you any harm. One pint did all the harm.
The Glasgow drunk has always been a brand leader with a bottle of fortified wine, barred off licences and staggering men in dark alleyways. But there is still some truth in the image, and there are still some men drinking to escape from difficult lives. Many Glaswegians prefer to forget the reputation generated by No Mean City, gangs and Rangers and Celtic. Scottish pubs have tended to be rather utilitarian places, without windows, for men to talk and drink. The simpler, older pubs survive alongside the new wine bars. Young Glaswegians, of both sexes, now relax over the drinks and surroundings more suited to a Hollywood film set. Since the change to all-day drinking 10 years ago, there's no fighting in the streets or the mad 10 p.m. drink-up rush. Drinking is more social and less desperate, and the images, music and jokes about drink have changed accordingly. But the old realities have not totally vanished.